Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Kanika from Kanak Jaipur, and today I am at Expression Studio and sharing a video tutorial. Keeping in mind the festive season is round the corner, so here I have a tutorial for you all how you can make this gorgeous and colorful tea light. So one tea light has glitter finish and one has matte finish. So the materials which I will be using is this black heavy gesso. You can use black or white as per your wish. The next thing is this fairy dust in the color green. I will also use the fairy dust in the color blue. So the next product is this deco stone mini. These are just amazing deco stones which Expressions Craft has come up with. I will also be using the medium sized deco stones today in my project. Also, some of the chalk paints which I will be using are these curcumin yellow color chalk paint. These are amazing chalk paints. The next color is this grassy fields. And the next color is this flamingo punch. So I will be using multiple colors, and this is coral peony color. So the color choice is as per your wish. I had tried to use multiple colors, and the last color is this raspberry red. Apart from chalk paint, I will also use sprinkle mist in the color persimmon. For the base, I will be using this metal tea light holder which I have, and I'll just decorate it and use the products from Expression Craft. So let's get started. As my base is of metal and I need to use the chalk paints, so here I'm applying a coat of white gesso. As the gesso is a base coat which you apply, so onto metal I would really recommend to apply a base coat of gesso and then use the chalk colors. So if you are using these amazing glitters from IM Mix, then don't forget to participate in the current month's challenge, and you can get a chance to win 1000 rupees voucher from Expressions Craft. Also, you know that I just love the chalk paints and the colors from Expressions Craft. You might have seen my previous videos of DIY mirror and altered box. Here I am covering the tea light from front as well as from back so that everything looks very even. So I'll just let it dry. On the back side, I have just chalk paint using the color raspberry red and given it an even coat so that it looks very professionally done. On to the front side, in the center, I have just sprinkled using the persimmon color sprinkle mist and covered it. I use the sprinkle mist so that it has the color deviation of red only. I'll be decorating it using the deco stones. So here I'm applying a thick coat of clear adhesive onto my base. Then onto the center areas, I'll be using the medium sized deco stones, and on the sides I will use the deco stones mini, as you can see in the video. So you can decide the placement of medium sized deco stones using your tweezers. You can easily move and work around. Now I'm applying the adhesive onto the sides of the star, and then I will cover that using the deco stones mini. This is totally as per your choice how you want the decoration and how you are placing your deco stones. I preferred using it this way as it would look more appealing to me. So the usage of deco stones is very much versatile. So I'll just cover up everything using these deco stones. Like, I'll just cover up everything using the combination of medium and mini deco stones today. These are not yet colored, but these are looking so beautiful as it is. One thing I would highly recommend you to do is use a very strong and a clear adhesive so that the deco stones stick to your base very well. This is the last area which I have to cover using the deco stones. While you are using and making this, make sure that you are covering each and every side so that it looks more even, and allow the adhesive to dry for at least 30 to 45 minutes so that it dries very well. I had let it dry for almost an hour, and now I'm just removing the extra. I'm tapping off very hard so that the extra stones get removed. Next, I have applied the adhesive on the inner rim as well, and now I will cover this using the mini stones. So this is how finally it looks. Now what you can do is just rub off your fingers onto the base so that the extra stones get removed. Make sure you're very gentle and not too harsh. Let's start the coloring process. Here I'm starting off by taking the curcumin color chalk paint, and I'm using a round brush. I'm just taking out a very little color, and you'll see I'll cover the whole area onto where I have to apply the yellow color, and I'm just pressing it hard so that the color gets deep inside the base as well. So the color combinations are as per your choice. I wanted it to make it a little bit more colorful, so I had choose 5 colors, but the chalk paints from Expressions Craft are so versatile and so good that you can use them in various ways. Also, I have used them in my previous various DIY tutorials. So if you are new, then check out those video tutorials as well. So this is how the first color looks like when completed. Next, I am taking up the grassy fields color and applying it like the way I have applied the yellow color. Just make sure that you are covering everything using the chalk paints, as the white color should not be visible. Glitter onto your project. So the first way I have already shared in my tutorial of the mirror, DIY mirror. So in that, what I did is I just added the glitters when my chalk paint are wet. So when the chalk paint is wet, the glitter easily sticks to your base. Now I'm using the third color, that is Flamingo Punch. So the first way I have already told you to how add glitter onto your project. The second way is that when you are done coloring the project, just add a liquid adhesive which dries clear, and then onto that just sprinkle your glitters. What will happen is the project will get evenly covered with the glitter. So here I'm using the fourth color, that is Coral Peony. As it is a festive season and the season is full of lights, so I thought why not to make it more colorful and decorate something different which easily anyone can do using these products. Also, if you're recreating any of the projects while watching our tutorials, then do share the pictures with us. We would love to see them and post those pictures on our social media as well. So here I'm just giving it up to the final touch, as I'm just about to complete the coloring process. I hope you're liking the tutorial, then click on the like button, and if you're new, then don't forget to subscribe. So this is the final outcome. This is the matte finish. I have not applied the glitters, and onto this I have applied the glitters. So now you can see the clear difference between the two tea lights. Camera is not doing justice right now to showcase the colors, but have a look on these pictures which I have attached to the video. So this is how the matte finished looked like, and this is how the glittered one looked like. I had added the blue and green fairy dust. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So see you until next time. Till then, happy crafting. And thanks for watching the video. So I hope you liked it. Then don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel. Happy crafting.